I'm Chad Copeland. A decade in the United States military taught me how to get into the most impossible places on Earth. National Geographic, the BBC, and Microsoft have sent me into the wild chasing ethereal moments through the lens of a camera. Now, I'm taking on Central Oregon's rugged terrain, and I'm going to show you how to adventure, eat, and enjoy the arts in the high desert. Splitting the state in half is the Cascade Mountain Range, and in it lies the second largest wilderness in Oregon, enclosed by the Three Sisters Peaks, Faith, Hope, and Charity. The wilderness borders Central Oregon's western side and provides endless outdoor adventure opportunities. Most of those adventures can be shared with our ever-curious adventure dogs. Ranch dogs, hunting dogs, and trail partners, our dogs are our favorite companions. Numerous global outdoor companies call Central Oregon home, elevating the local experience, and with over 1 million acres of national forest, the possibilities of camping and adventuring with your dog are endless. The best way to start an adventure in the wilderness is with a fresh cup of coffee. I'm hiking with second-generation business owners Justin, Jared, and Bend Businesswoman of the Year, Jesse Durham, in the Sisters Wilderness with my best furry friend, Maya.
We're so fortunate to be out here in the wild Sisters country. What are we drinking first?
So today, we actually have a really special coffee that we're going to be drinking. Yeah. It's from Brazil. It's a micro lot from Minas Gerais region. It's actually a Cup of Excellence winner. I just wanted to showcase it today because I think it's really special.
Tell me about the brewing process.
So today, we are going to start with approximately 28 grams of coffee and 400 milliliters of hot water. Okay. And I'm going to start the brewing process here in just a moment with the wonderful coffee that Jesse has shared with us. And I'm just going to give this a go right now. So we're going to start about 30 grams of hot water, and we're going to let that steep and let the blooming process start, mm-hmm. where the gases are released from the coffee grounds. And then after about 30 seconds, we're going to continue to add 50 to 100 milliliters of water until our brewing process is complete. It should take about 3 minutes total, and then we'll have our delicious cup of coffee to share out here in Sisters Country.
What's your process for adventuring? Do you take your coffee before or after you go out?
Well, I think, more the better, yeah.
I'd love to have the experience of cupping, and it sounds like you guys do that at Sisters Coffee.
We'd love to have you out.
Oh, I'd love to do that.
Yeah, that would be great. You should come down.
I'd love to. Let me go do a thing, and I'll be in. Thanks, guys.
Cheers, team.
Cheers.
Cheers. How else are you going to hike down the trail unless you have a nice cup of coffee?
It's probably just not possible.
I wouldn't think so.
All right, cheers to that.
Not only is Bend in Central Oregon the adventure capital of the Pacific Northwest, but it's also known as Dogtown USA, with 49% of the people in Central Oregon having a dog. Jill Rosell is a professional photographer and the top dog photographer in Central Oregon, and shows us how to capture those amazing moments of our best friends. In a place that sees 300 days of sunshine, a little mountain rain is welcome.
I'm actually from two little islands in the southern hemisphere called Brazil. So I've been away for many years, but I did find Bend in 2000. It actually reminded me a lot of home in New Zealand. So I've been doing portraits since 2009, and naturally I've been photographing dogs without realizing, and now I've decided to specify dogs a lot more. Central Oregon is my studio. I have this beautiful outdoor scenic visuals to put my dogs and play in, so it's the perfect spot for me.
Tell me about our first spot for the day.
We have a young Waimarama called Mo. I'm going to have her do some action for me. Apparently she's got good commands, so we'll see what she does, but she's beautiful.
What are you going to do to get the shot?
I'm going to get low. I really like the act that it's more dramatic when I'm down low with the dog, especially when it's hopefully flying through the air at me. We're going to utilize a bull to get her moving. Apparently that's going to work.
Sure.
We shall see.
Yeah, you're going to throw it right at me. Okay, let's try it. Go for it. Awesome. Yeah, that was easy.
Yeah, Pete, you think you can get it right up?
Good girl. Beautiful. I'm just gonna get a face. Good girl. Perfect.
Good boy, thanks. Good boy.
Oh, so good.
Taking the Durhams up on their offer, I'm heading into Sisters for my first experience with coffee roasting, testing, and grading, and enjoy the family legacy's story in their home away from home, the cafe.
So I heard that Sisters Coffee, it actually started in Alaska, and it was called the
Coffee Express.
The Coffee Express.
Mom and Dad, they had a coffee shop in Sitka, Alaska, where we were living at the time. We're native Oregonians, but we were living in Alaska, and so they started this coffee shop. They just really loved the idea of roasting really high-quality coffee and serving people.
There's always an interesting dynamic when, you know, parents start something and it becomes a legacy. How did you guys decide that this is what you wanted to do?
It's a gift that we're in a position to, you know, really have a dream come true, where Mom and Dad are able to pass the business on to us, and then we're able to own it and grow the brand in a, you know, new way, build on their legacy.
Talking about coffee culture in general, you know, I'm really familiar with wine. I know that there's all different types of, you know, like professional wine applications. What's that look like in the coffee world?
We've got this incredible beverage that is comprised of 1,500 different aromatic compounds, which is actually double the amount that's in wine.
So the cupping process is meant to take a subjective thing, taste, and make it as empirical as possible. So the cupping process is how we assess and assign that economic value, and then also assess how we're going to use a coffee for our production.
So we'll pick it up, give it a shake, and then we'll put our nose right in there and we'll give three quick sniffs.
Okay.
And we'll just kind of think about what we're smelling, relate it to tastes and experiences that you've had. We have 2.5 minutes left for them to brew.
Okay.
So as they're brewing, we'll assess the aromas.
Get close
and three quick breaths. So we're gonna taste it with a spoon.
With a spoon.
Yep.
Okay.
And we're gonna slurp it, which is the most fun part of this process, and
excellent,
also the loudest. So we'll get like 2/3 of a spoon. We'll bring it up to our mouth and we'll kind of keep our mouth closed and we'll go.
Super weak on my side, I'll tell you right now. All right, the results.
Yeah.
I give a 86.75. So from a professional standpoint, what would you rate number one?
I'd rate it an 85.25.
Excellent.
Set in the foothills of the Cascade Mountain Range and minutes from the bustling town of Bend, the Sun River Resort is a prime destination for adventure-filled vacations with world-class golfing, endless biking trails, and is a dog-friendly community. Sun River Resort offers a variety of indoor and outdoor dining options where fine dining experiences can be had at the resort's 5 restaurants. I'm meeting with executive chef Joshua Hendrick at Carson's American Kitchen to get the best tips and tricks in his kitchen.
So we're going to start working on the coho. Coho is extremely Oregon. This is wild Oregon coho. We try as a resort to be as Oregon as is humanly possible. Basically, hot pans, right?
Yeah.
A little bit of oil. Quick trick for cooking fish.
Okay.
So take your pan, whatever pan you want to use, it doesn't matter what it's made out of. Put oil in it and wait until it smokes. Then dump that oil out, put cold oil in, and your fish will never, ever, ever, ever stick.
Really?
I'm gonna show you. After we get it going, you're not stuck anymore. We're just gonna throw it in the oven. For this dish, I'm gonna use snap peas, English peas, and then pea tendrils. So as many parts of the pea plant and as many peas as I can find, I have on this plate. It's a lot of parsley and tarragon, a lot of marjoram, a lot of oregano. And that's what we want. See that nice color? Everything's changed, but we're not going brown at all.
Yeah.
Should still be crispy. Take our fish.
Height, sorry.
There you go. Height sexy, right?
Nice. How do you feel about cooking for dogs, Chef?
You know, I'm gonna be honest with you. I'm in the business of hospitality.
So if a guest comes in and is more than happy to buy their dog a steak,
right.
I'm more than happy to make a steak for a dog.
I love that.
I even take temperature. Right?
You do too.
Some dogs actually prefer mid-rare medium.
So I've got a dog, her name is Maya.
Maya, cool.
We're gonna meet her outside in a few minutes.
Yeah.
Let's try that mid-rare steak.
Mid-rare, sure. Let's fire a mid-rare flat iron for her. Our flat iron is actually prime beef. I've tried lesser beef for flat iron, and it's just never as good.
Okay.
You know, plenty of salt, although for your pup, I'm gonna back it off a little bit. You can do this in a pan, you can do this in a grill. We just happen to have a nice flat top up here.
Thing to know about steaks, you need to rest a steak for at least half of the amount of time that you cook a steak.
Gonna cut. I hope Maya will be happy. I'll be pretty embarrassed if Maya doesn't like my food.
Flat iron a pup.
Tell me a little bit about the sustainability and sourcing locally.
Kelsey is really, you know, at the forefront of a big initiative for the resort this year, and not just this year, but really moving forward. We really looked at our industry as a whole and found that especially food and beverage, mm-hmm. you know, is more I can speak on obviously than other parts of the resort, is exceedingly wasteful, right? So I did some pretty easy math a couple weeks ago and realized that my kitchen, and we have five kitchens on the property.
Okay.
I used 36 miles of plastic wrap last year.
Oh my gosh.
I, as the chef of Carson's, and then, you know, in working with our sustainability council, I'm trying to cut that down by 80% this year. So we're really looking at, why are we using single-use plastics? Do we need to have those plastics on the property? And what can we use as an alternative? So,
okay.
I think as a resort, we really have a responsibility to be leaders in sustainability. We live in such a beautiful place, it's such a naturally wonderful location. We, as leaders at Sun River, have that responsibility to carry it on for generations to come. So starting in November, our main kitchen as well as our banquet kitchen, which are the two largest on property, transition to a composting program. We've been able to defer a significant amount from the landfill to compostable sources, and all of our cutlery, all of our to-go ware, those are all compostable items now. Wow.
Heading back to the resort for a dog show of sport with Canine Kings. World, national, and state champion J.D. Platt and his dogs have been featured on Animal Planet's Pet Star and appeared on the dog reality show on CBS called Greatest American Dog.
I toured the country with a team of 9 dogs. I've trained them to do some pretty amazing acrobatic tricks. We toured the country doing all sorts of different venues, been doing this for about 25 years. I love Central Oregon, kind of my lifestyle. This is an amazing place for dogs, amazing place for outdoor activities, and I just absolutely love it here. I've trained about 25 dogs over the last 25 years, and you know, every single one is real different. I've tried to apply my training techniques to every single dog because of their different characteristics, their personalities. You really have to adjust your training, and us humans can learn a lot from dogs as far as that tail wag. It's just a simple thing, but it goes a long ways with the smile, the enjoyment of no matter where you've been, how long you've been gone, that tail wag goes a long ways with dogs and the love they have for humans. Each of the performances are designed pretty much the same way, but the beauty of animals is it's always different. You know, she might do this trick, but she might do something quirky that just kind of brings out something different in my show, so every single show is different.
We're out here at Sun River. What are we gonna see today?
There's a lot you're gonna see out here, a lot of acrobatic stuff.
Okay.
But if we're outdoor activity people, you always gotta make sure before you do anything physically active, you always gotta make sure you stretch.
What's first?
We are gonna bring out my Catahoula leopard dog.
Okay.
One of the rarest breeds in the world, a really hardcore working dog. It was bred in Louisiana and hunt wild boar. I've taught this dog an amazing, amazing launching trick. So as far as training my dogs, as far as learning Frisbee, I do a lot of little rollers on the ground, sliders, and then when it comes to the big vaulting maneuvers, I try to get them real comfortable with going over my body parts, over the leg, back and forth, sometimes underneath, over the chest, things like that.
Heading into the Great Hall with my best friend Maya to watch local musician Casey Flynn. The Great Hall is the resort's flagship venue, and it is known for its rich history, beginning as an Army Officers Club built in 1941 by the Army Corps of Engineers. The high beams and natural cut logs create a majestic room and incredible atmosphere.
What are the origins of the Great Hall?
This facility actually started as Camp Abbott.
Okay.
So during World War II, the Army Corps of Engineers found this place because of the Deschutes River. So what they were doing is they were going to train officers on how to blow up bridges and then send them over to war. So they came in here, they found this amazing place, they named it Camp Abbott, and they immediately started construction of the Officers Club, which we now call the Great Hall.
I grew up in Portland, Oregon, never was a big fan of rain, and I was a tennis player. There's always tennis tournaments over here in Central Oregon, so we used to come over here quite a bit for vacations and tennis tournaments and stuff, and I always thought, one day I'm going to live there because it doesn't rain here, and it smells like pine. My wife and I wrote our own wedding song. It was called With This Ring, and it was a duet. We recorded it at a studio and played it at our wedding. That was our first dance. Central Oregon is really the ultimate playground. You know, four seasons, four full seasons, and really anything you could think of outdoors is right here within 15 minutes to 30 minutes from anywhere you're at. You could pretty much call your shot and do it.
Well, I'd like to stay, but we're leaving tomorrow. We're lucky they don't run us out on a rail. If you don't get enough, you can feel free to follow. Next stop is 6 days on the grounds by the bay.
Sun River Resort is a golfer's paradise and an ideal choice for a golf vacation. Each of the four golf courses was designed by acclaimed architect Bob Cupp. Graced with preserved wetlands, forested meadows, and sparkling waters, the Sun River Resort offers 63 holes of the best golf in the West.
The golf course was designed in 1995 and built in the same year by Robert Cupp. It has bent grass tee boxes, fairways, and greens with a bluegrass rough. The unique part about Crosswater is not only the design of the course, which is a Heathland-style golf course, kind of pairing together the links courses of Scotland and Ireland, paired with those park-style courses of the United States here. Not to mention all of the outdoors activities that you can do right here on Crosswater's property. In Central Oregon at Sun River itself. We've hosted a myriad of events such as the NCAA championships. In the late 2000s, we hosted the Geldwin tournament. We've also been host to the PGA Professional National Championship a number of times. The wildlife here is certainly unique and vast, being in the woods and the wetlands areas. On hole 13, we have a bald eagle's nest, where essentially a mother and father bald eagle return every spring. They hatch some children, and then we get to see them go through the process of them leaving the nest, learning how to eat and feed themselves. Then they leave for the winter time, and year after year they return.
It's no wonder why Crosswater is one of the top golf courses in the United States, especially according to Condé Nast. I've got Mount Bachelor just peeking through the clouds back there. You know, it's late spring, and it's beautiful.
Well, from the tee box we were on, it's a 635-yard hole. So we actually hit some good drives out here, but we're still well over 300 yards away. Well, hole number 9 here at Crosswater, as you can see, it crosses over the Little Deschutes River, and then the river runs all the way up the right side of the hole, heading straight back towards the Cascade Mountain Range. Pretty straightforward, par 4. Not much to it. Once we get up to the green, though, you'll see it's very, very large.
I think this might be the most beautiful hole I've seen so far. Hey, they both went over.
I nailed it.
After an exceptional round of golf, the only thing that can top my day is a scotch by the fire at the Crosswater Clubhouse with Josh Willis, Director of Golf Operations.
I understand that Crosswater is
and all the other golf courses that are here at Sun River are really great for families.
Yeah, it's a really great place to be, and Sun River Resort is a real generational property here in the Pacific Northwest.
I've seen some of the luxury rentals just going through the course today. Can you tell me a little bit about those?
Yeah, we have over 300 vacation rentals here in our property management rental pool at Sun River Resort. Most of them are in the Sun River Resort community, as well as the Caldera community, which is the newest development we have here at Sun River Resort.
What is the culture of Sun River?
Bikes.
Bikes?
The community itself has 34 miles of bike paths, that's in Sun River community. Wow. And since then, we've with the development of Caldera as well as Crosswater, we have endless bike paths.
Can you tell me about the course here at Crosswater?
Yeah, so Crosswater, this development opened in 1995. When we opened Crosswater, it was the longest golf course in America. So from the tips, it's 7,683 yards. You know, what makes the place really special is it's built in a meadow.
Mm-hmm.
And in this meadow, we have 600 plus acres, and 200 of it is a bent grass golf course. 200 of it are native fescues and wetlands, and then we have 200 acres designated to the housing development here. We have 120 homes in this community. This place is just amazing. I mean, the wildlife we have here, and to have a golf course built bordering and going back and forth across the Big Deschutes and the Little Deschutes River is just something you can't find anywhere else in the world.
Always the entrepreneur, JD took his love for dogs and his incredible innovation to the water and started a SUP business, making inflatable boards with a platform to accommodate our canine friends.
You know, I love having my dog with me everywhere I go. And I love that there's now an opportunity to have a stable board to put my dog on. Tell me a little bit about the SUP culture and the culture of the dogs in Central Oregon that you're familiar with.
Well, we all know Central Oregon is one of the top outdoor lifestyle places in the country, let alone the world. And they've ranked Central Oregon and Bend, Oregon to be one of the top three paddleboard places in the country. So a lot of people are getting involved in it. We see it down the Deschutes River, a lot of floaters and paddleboarders, and it's a culture that's really grown over the years. And always really enjoyed the water with kayaks and fell in love with paddleboarding. I just love the exercise. I love being out on the water. Now my dogs, they join me, and all nine I have absolutely love it.
What do you know about this being Dogtown, USA?
Yep, I don't know how many things we can be ranked in the top three, but
That's one of them.
It's Dogtown, USA, and there's a lot of places I've been with a lot of people that own dogs, but I think per capita, they say it's number one in the world or something like that, so
like
I believe it.
Dog for every three people.
Uh-huh, I believe it. The breweries that we go to and all the trails, and it's a lot of dog friendliness, and Bend Parks and Rec has really embraced the dog culture, and Central Oregon in general has just been dog friendly. I've been here 40 years and always had a dog, and just really seen the love of people and their dogs around here.
With a majestic backdrop of the Cascade Range, adventuring outdoors and camping with our dogs, family, and friends in Central Oregon is one of life's biggest enjoyments. Our best friends thrive in the open air with freedom to roam, explore, and have the closeness with us.
Micah, I want to tell you about your dad. His name was Forrest. Your dad's name was Forrest, Maya. Forrest was 8 years old when he passed, but man, did we have some crazy experiences. Climbed to the tallest peaks, roamed the lowest canyons. He was my best friend, and everybody knew it.
The beauty of our dog-loving community here in Central Oregon is that visiting dogs are always welcome. From dog-friendly resorts, pubs, and restaurants to off-leash trails and dog parks by the river, Central Oregon is Dogtown, USA. Next time on Adventure Calls. Central Oregon has been a long-time destination for travelers seeking to unwind and experience the outdoors. Born from the timber industry, the region is now a hotbed for adventure, culture, and culinary experiences.
Beautiful departure out of Blackbeauty Ranch.
Yeah, it's an awesome day to be flying.
What do you love most about flying in Central Oregon?
The views never get old. With every season, it changes completely. You always see something different. It's the coolest perspective.
I'm Chad Copeland, and this is Adventure Calls.